Hi friends, in this video I'm going to write a simple Java program to find the last element in a given array using the reduce method and skip method. Using the reduce method, we can find out the last element in an array. The syntax for the reduce method is it takes the first and the second argument in a given array and it performs the given operation. In this scenario, I don't have any business logic here. I've informed just pick up the second element. So using the reduce method, it's going to iterate the stream of elements one by one and pick up the second parameter. And finally, we'll be getting the last element. That's how we use the reduce method to find the last element. Using the skip method, we can also find out the last element. It's very straightforward. We have to give a long value. Here we say skip 5 elements. So the first 5 elements will be skipped and we'll be getting the last element. Let's see the program now. I've created a class called LastElement and a list of words and two methods. One is using reduce and the other one is using skip. So in the reduce method, I create a stream out of this list and then call reduce passing the first parameter and the second parameter. There is no business logic to be executed. I have to pick up the second parameter. So it keeps on iterating the elements in an array and finally we reach the last element. So this will be stored in this variable and we print in the console. Using skip, it's straightforward. We create a stream out of the list and directly we find out the list size minus 1. That means skip the first 5 elements and get the last element and print it in the console. So when I run this program, the last element using reduce and skip is displayed in the console. Please try out. Hope this video is useful. Thank you.